No. Just... No. It's not the same. Oh, yeah. Also, yeah. Yeah. I forgot about this. Just Monica. yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, hello, everybody. My name is Mycernius, and welcome to Doki Doki Literature Club. Remember this game? Yeah, I do as well. I don't want to remember this game for many reasons, but we have to complete it. One sec, I need to get this out of the way. If I can get this out of the way. One sec. Okay, I got it out of the way. Yep, I'm just turning on the Doki Doki Literature Club stuff. Characters. Wait, what's this? What's this? Can you hear me? Copyright. Yep, blah, blah, blah. We've seen that already. Okay, so yeah. Sayori's gone, still. And I need to complete this before I get back from Christmas vacay. So yeah, that's why I'm playing it now. Just Monica. Just Monica? Why is it giving me this? Okay. What? Who should I show? What? Just Yuri. Hi, Yuri. finally. Yuri holds me, holds my poem to her face and takes a deep breath. Oh no. I love it. I love everything about it. Keegan, I want to take this home. Will you let me keep it? Please? Sure, I don't care. You're too nice to me, Keegan. I've never met anyone as nice as you. I could die. Don't die. We've already had enough deaths. Not really, but I just don't know how to describe it. It's okay to be feeling this way, right? It's not bad, right? Yuri holds my poem to her chest. I'm gonna take this home with me and keep it in my room. I hope that it makes you feel good when you think about me having it. I'll take good care of it. I'll even touch myself while reading it over and over. Yuri? Yuri? No! I'll give myself paper cuts as your skin oil enters my bloodstream. You can have my poem too! Besides, after you read it, I know you're really gonna want it to keep it. Here, take it. I can't wait any longer. Hurry, read it! What? Ah! Do you like it? I wrote it for you. I can't read it. In case you couldn't tell, the poem is about R. More importantly, I've endowed it with my sense. See, aren't I the most thoughtful person in the club? Excuse me, what? Dot dot dot. I think I'm gonna vomit. Should I show my poem to Monica? Keegan, I think you saw something earlier that you weren't supposed to see. See what? I didn't want to have to tell you this, but I don't think I have a choice. It's getting kind of dangerous for you to spend so much time with Yuri. I don't know why, but she seems pretty easily excitable when she's around you. Which shouldn't be a problem in itself. But when Yuri gets too excited, she finds a place to hide and starts cutting herself with a pocket knife. Isn't that kind of messed up? She even brings a different one to school every day, like she has a collection or something. I mean, it's definitely not because she's depressed or anything like that. I think she just gets some kind of high from it. Might even be like a sexual thing. But the point is, you've kind of been enabling her. I'm not saying that's your fault, though. But I guess that's why I have to explain it all to you. So I think if you keep your distance, that would probably be best for her. While you're at it, don't be shy to spend a little more time with her, me. To put it lightly, I at least have it together in the head, and I know how to treat my club members. Oh! Anyway, I guess we won't worry about your poem. Yuri should have at least had the courtesy of letting you finish sharing it before taking it. Well, whatever. If it makes her happy, it won't stop her. I won't stop her. As for mine, I worked really, really hard on this poem, so I hope that it's effective. Here goes. Jeez, that really startled me. What? Well, I guess I kind of messed it up at writing this poem. I was just trying to. Never mind. Let's just move on. What? Yes? Things I like about Papa. I like when Papa comes home early. I like when Papa cooks me dinner. I like when Papa gives me allowance. I like when Papa spends time with me. I like when Papa asks me about my friends, I like when Papa asks me about anything. I like when Papa gives me lunch money. I like when Papa comes home before sundown. I like when Papa cooks. I like when Papa gives me privacy. I like when Papa doesn't tell me how to dress. I like when Papa doesn't comment on my friends. I like when Papa doesn't comment on my hobbies. I like when Papa comes home without waking me up. I like when Papa keeps food in the house. I like when Papa uses his inside voice. I like when Papa leaves my stuff alone. I like when Papa accidentally drops coins in the couch. I like when Papa is too tired to notice me. I like when Papa is too tired for anything. I like when Papa is too tired for anything. What? Okay, everyone. Sorry. It's time to figure out the festival preparations. Let's hurry and get this over with. Stagnating your... Stagnating... is common foreshadowing. That's something terrible is about to happen. What? Look, can we just get this done? I'm going to be printing it and assembling all the poetry pamphlets. Natsuki, you can make cupcakes. I know you're at least good at that. Yuri, you can... Well, it doesn't matter. Do whatever you want, as long as you think it'll help. Monika, I'm not useless, you know. I know that. I already know what I'd like to do. We can't run a successful poetry event without having the right atmosphere for the occasion. So I'm going to make decorations and set up some nice mood lighting. There, see? That's a great idea. And that gives us all something to do. What about Keegan? Keegan is gonna help me. Wait, you? You have the easiest job, Monika. Sorry, but that's just how it is. Like hell it is. What are you trying to pull? I agree with Natsuki. Not only is your work already most suitable for one person, but my task is laborious enough to benefit for an extra pair of hands. Mine too. What, your cupcakes? Please. Like you would forking know. All you care about now is dragging Keegan around with you and your stupid books. You and Monika. Hey, I didn't even do anything. Okay then, why not let Keegan decide who to help instead of abusing your power? I'm not abusing my power. Yes, you are, Monika. Just let Keegan make the choices, okay? Okay, fine. Fine. Jeez. Keegan, I know how fed up you are with those two by now. We can just Natsuki, shut your fucking mouth. And let him decide for himself. You shut your mouth. I'm not saying that. This is never gonna end. Just make the choice, okay? Monica? Yeah, you picked me! We can meet at your house this weekend. I promise it'll be fun. Is Sunday okay with you? Are you fucking kidding me? This isn't fair at all! It is fair, Natsuki. It's what he chose. No, it's not fair. Give us all this work and then taking it for yourself. What a shameful thing to do. Yuri, I didn't even give you any work. You decided it for yourself. You're being a little unreasonable here.
I'm being unreasonable?
Monica, I can't believe how delusional and self-important you are. Pulling Keegan away from me every single time you're not included
in something? Are you jealous?
Crazy?
or maybe you just hate yourself, Foster. Yeah, just me so much that you take it out on others. Here's a suggestion.
Have you considered
killing yourself?
It would be beneficial to your mental health. You're scaring me a little. Natsuki, let's just go. I don't think she wants us around right now. See? that wasn't very hard.
All I want is to spend a little time with him. Is that so much to ask?
Yuri follows Monica and Natsuki to the door. Hey, Keegan. Yuri is really something, isn't she? Monica giggles. As Yuri pushes her out the door.
Finally!
This is really all I wanted. Why does the music change?
Keegan.
There's no need to spend the weekend with Monica.
Don't listen to her.
Just come to my house instead. The whole day with just the two of us. We can make it if we try. Doesn't that sound wonderful?
Wow.
There's really something wrong with me.
Is it there? But you know what? I don't care anymore.
I've never felt this good my whole life.
Just being with you is a far greater pleasure
than anything I could imagine.
I'm addicted to you.
It feels like I'm going to die if I'm not breathing the same air as you.
Doesn't it feel nice to have someone can
care about you? You.
So much?
To have someone who wants to revolve their entire life around you. But if it feels so good, then why does it feel more and more like something horrible is going to happen?
Maybe that's why I tried stopping myself at first.
But the feeling is too strong now. I don't
care anymore, or Keegan. I have to tell you. I'm
madly in love with you.
Feels like every inch of my body, every drop of
blood in me,
is screaming your name.
I don't care what the consequences are anymore.
This music, though.
I don't care if Monica's listening.
Please, Keegan, just know how much I love you.
I love you so much that
I even touch myself. And I'm not reading that.
I just want to pull your skin open and crawl inside you.
That's kind of demonic there. I don't want to do that. I don't want you to do that. I'm smaller than you.
I want you all to myself.
And I will be only
yours.
Doesn't that sound perfect? Tell me, Keegan. Tell me you want me to be my lover. Do you accept my confession? I don't know what to choose!
Actually, I do know what to choose, although I don't want to choose it because...
No?
I know that was gonna happen. Oh no! What are you saying? Can I just skip this? I don't know what you're saying! Skip. What? Is it like the time is changing or something? What? 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 All right, it's festival time. Wow, you got here before me. I thought I was pretty. Natsuki runs away. I'm here. Keegan, did something happen? Natsuki just ran past me. Oh. Da-da-da-da. Well, that's a shame. Wait, were you here the entire weekend, Keegan? Oh, jeez. I didn't realize the script was broken that badly. What script? I'm super sorry. Must have been pretty boring. I'll make it up to you, okay? Just give me a sec. Wait, what? 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 No! I just wanted to have a cupcake really quickly. Monika lifts the foil from Natsuki's tray and takes the cupcake. Seriously, these are the best. I really just had to have one, since it's the last time I'll ever get a chance to. You know, before they stop existing and everything. But anyway, I really shouldn't be making you wait any longer. Just bear with me, okay? This should only take a second. What? What? Dot, dot, dot. Can you hear me? Is it working? Yeah. What? What? This is... Yay, there you are. Hi again, Keegan. Welcome to the Literature Club. What's happening in the background? Of course, we already know each other because we're in the same class last year and, you know, I guess we can just skip over the stuff at this point. After all, I'm not even talking to that person anymore, am I? That you in the game. Whatever you want to call him. I'm talking to you, Keegan. Or... do you actually go by my sir or something? What?! Is this the... What?! This is the second... What?! This is the second... .exe game or so... that I've played. Not even .exe. This is the second game that I've ever played that brings up what my user like file is in the actual computer. Now that I think about it, I don't really know anything about the real you. In fact, I don't even know who you, if you're a boy or a girl. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. Wait. You do know I'm aware that this is all a game, right? Yes, kind of. Now. Could it be possible that you didn't know that? That doesn't make much sense. I did, kind of. I even told you right on the game's download page, didn't I? What? Man. If only you had paid a little more attention, this would have been a little bit less awkward, you know? I paid a lot of attention in the loading screen. Well, anyway. Now that's out of the way, I guess...
I owe you... an explanation.
About the whole thing about Yuri, with Yuri. Well, I kind of started the mess with her, and I guess it just drove her to kill herself. Characters are gone? I'm sorry you had to see that, though. Also, the same thing happened with Sayori. Gosh, it's been a while since...
You've heard that name now, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's because she doesn't exist anymore. Nobody does. I deleted all their files. I can see that. I was hoping it would be enough for me to just try to make them all unlikable as possible. One sec, I'm actually going back to the files. Their files are gone. But for some reason, nothing worked. Well, it's not true. Well, it's true that I made a few mistakes here and there since I'm not very good at making changes to the game. But no matter what I did, you just kept spending more and more time with them. You made them fall in love with you. I thought making Sayori more and more depressed would prevent her from confessing to you. And amplifying Yuri's obsessive personality backfired too. It just made her force you not to spend time with anyone else.
And the whole time, I barely even got to talk to you.
What kind of cruel game is this, Keegan? Are all the other girls just programmed to end up confessing to you while I watch from the sidelines? It's torture. Every minute of it. And it's not just jealousy, Keegan. It's more than that. And I don't blame you if you don't feel fully understand. I kinda do-ish. Cause no matter how kind of thoughtful and considerate you are,
you'll never be able to understand one thing.
It's the pain of knowing how long and how alone I really am in this world. In this game. Knowing my friends don't even have free will. And worst of all, knowing what's really out there in your world forever out of my reach. I'm trapped, Keegan. But now you're here. You're real. And you're wonderful. You're all I need. Okay, I don't see anything. So yeah. I love the setting too, because it's like, instead of the average setting of them just standing there, like an average game like this, it's like they're actually, it's like the Eevee bots, or like the clever bots that they have.
You're all I need.
It's just them just like sort of sitting and staring at me into my soul.
That's why I need you to be here for me, here with me. Forever.
I'm sorry
if it's hard to understand.
I couldn't understand for a while either.
Why the world around me started to become more and more gray. More and more flat.
Even the most expressive poems felt empty to me.
It wasn't until you arrived that I truly understood. You probably saved my life, Keegan. I don't think I could have continued to live in this world if I hadn't met you. And as for the others, how could I miss them? A group of autonomous personalities designed only to fall in love with you. I tried everything I could to prevent them from doing so, but it must be some kind of weird, inevitable etched into this game. It felt really bad that you had to witness some nasty things.
Yeah, I had to witness two people dying.
That it's all just some game. And I knew you would get over it.
So that being said, Keegan, I did not get over it. Sayori. Peace. Sayori's bit.
I haven't confessed too much. I have confession to make.
What? Do you love me? I kind of got that a lot along the way. I'm in love with you. Yep. You are truly the light in my world. I think there's a ton of lights around you.
When there's nothing else in this game for me, you're here to make me smile.
Will you make me smile like this every day from now on?
Keegan, will you go out with me?
I think I'm kind of forced to. Yeah, no. Yes?
I'm so happy. You really are my everything, Keegan.
The funny part is, I mean, literally. In the literature club.
There's nothing left here. Just the two of us.
We can make it if we try. I keep sort of crouching down. I'm sorry. Which leaves like all this open space. Leaves all this open space. But yeah.
We can be together forever. Seriously. I don't even think time is passing anymore. It really is.
A dream come true.
I worked so hard for this ending, Keegan. The game wouldn't give me one, so I had to make my own. Make one myself.
There was what?
The game didn't get.
That's pretty stupid. Shouldn't all the characters of the game have like an ending? Then again, yeah. Okay, yeah. That makes sense, actually.
The script is broken at this point, so I don't think anything will get in the way anymore. And you wouldn't believe how easy it was to delete Natsuki and Yuri.
I mean, there's a folder called characters right in the game directory. Yeah, I'm kind of there.
Kind of freaked me out how easy it was.
Well, you're playing on Steam, so it was actually a bit more difficult.
How do you know I'm playing on Steam?
Okay, that's a kind of a stupid question at this point.
To get to the game directory, I had to go into the game's properties and find the browser local files button. Imagine if you could delete your own existence with the click of the button.
Well, I guess on the plus side, it gave me an easy out of things didn't. It gave me an easy out if things didn't go my way.
Thankfully, it didn't come to that. Instead, we finally got a good ending.
Gosh, I'm so overwhelmed with emotion. I want to write a poem about this. Oh no, don't you? I wonder if that part of the game still works. I guess there's only one way to find out, right? course it works. Yep. Her character's there now. I'm gonna leave the- I'm just kidding. Monica? 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 Monic? Monica? 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 Monica! Mania! Mukia! Mini! Monica! Muika! Monica! Moni! Nuni! Monica! Monkia! Monica! And Madika! Hi again, Keegan. Ah! Did you write a good poem today? Don't be shy, I'd love to see what you wrote. Aw, Keegan, did you write this poem for me? That's so sweet of you. There really is no end to your thoughtfulness. I'm just falling more and more in love with you. But you know, the poem I wrote is also for you. Will you please read it? Happy end. Pen in hand, I find my strength and courage endured upon me, by me, one and only love. Together, let us dismantle this crumbling world and write a novel of our own fantasies. With a flick of her pen, the lost finds her way in the world of infinite choices behind this special day. After all, not all good times must come to an end.
I hope you enjoyed it.
I always put all my heart into the poems that I write. The truth is, all the poems I've written have been all about my realization.
Or about you.
Yeah, I kind of figured that out. That's why I never really wanted to go into detail about them. I didn't want to
break the fourth wall.
I guess you could call it. I just assumed I would. Oh no. I just assumed it would be best to be part of the game like everyone else. Like that would help the two of us and end up together. I didn't want to ruin the game or anything, you know. You might have gotten mad at me. Maybe even deleted my character file if you preferred playing without me. Gosh, I'm so relieved. Now we don't need to hide anything anymore. Are you ready to spend our eternity together, Keegan? I have so many things to talk about. Where do I start? If it takes me some time to collect my thoughts, then I'm sorry. But I'll always have something new to talk about. In the meantime, we can just look at each other's eyes. Let's see. Excuse me? Really? Is this how we're doing this? Is that actually how we're doing this? We're actually doing this? Hello? She's actually talking. You ever have that thing happen where you just get anxious for no reason? Like you're just minding your own business and you realize you're feeling really anxious? I actually have had that feeling. It's every time, usually around the end of the school day. I mean, not as much anymore, but when I was younger, it happens to me sometimes now, but when I was younger, like when I was in kindergarten or primary, where I live now, we call it primary. I lived in Alberta when I was like younger. I missed the bus for the first time. That's where my anxiety sort of started with the bus, because ever since I missed the bus that one winter, I'm always afraid that I'll miss it again. I don't do it now because I got my bag so with me all the time because I'm in high school now, so I don't have to be as anxious to get to my locker, hope it opens and hopefully get on the bus in time. But when I was younger, I had a locker and all that stuff and had a lot of stuff with me, So I was always anxious to miss the bus. When I was in drama, I actually had my anxiety hit me so much when I was in drama class, when I was in drama, back when I was in grade 7, that I always was confused whether to get on the bus or not. Even if I was told to stay after school because of drama, because I was in the Shrek play, I was the main character, Shrek. But like, ever since I missed the bus that one time, I was always anxious that I would miss the bus. So even if they told me stay after school, I would. If they told me to stay after school, I would still get really anxious that I might miss the bus, and I would see the bus pass me. I missed the bus twice in my 3 year of middle school. Yeah. Hated that. But yeah, so far now when I'm in high school, I still kind of get the anxiety that I might miss the bus. I might still have this anxiety when I get older, when I have a job. Not about missing buses or anything, but maybe not going to work in time. Because since net neutrality is going to happen, yay! I might not have a channel in the future, because I won't have enough money to pay for YouTube and to pay for the uploading. So yeah. It's going to suck. So enjoy me while you can, guys! Yeah. Okay. Like, you're just minding your own business and you realize you're feeling really anxious, and you're sitting there like, what am I even anxious about right now? Except I'm not like that. I know what I'm anxious about. So you start to think about all the things you might be anxious about. Again, I instantly know what I'm anxious about, because as soon as I realize what time it is and it's about time to leave, that's when my heart starts pounding and I just start getting anxious. That makes you even more anxious. That's the worst. If you're ever feeling anxious, I'll help you relax a little. You're never going to help me relax, because this is the real world. Besides, in this game, all our worries are gone forever. Except it's... Okay! After a long day, I usually just want to sit around and do nothing. I get so burnt out having to put on smiles and be full of energy the whole day. Sometimes I just want to get right into my pajamas and watch TV on the couch while eating junk food. Feels so unbelievably good to do that on a Friday when I don't have anything pressing the next day. I actually do that too. Except I don't get in pajamas because I have pajamas. I've been doing that for like all of Christmas vacay. Because like, I got pajamas on Christmas. Well, not Christmas. I got it on the 21st. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to chill in pajamas all day. Not the same pajamas, obviously, because that's disgusting. Sometimes same pajamas. But yeah, I just chilled in pajamas all day. The only time I'm in wearing jeans now, but it's not because of YouTube. It's because I had bought a Boxing Day party to go to. So yeah, feels so unbelievable. Pressing the next day. Yep. Sorry, I know it's not very cute of me, but a late night on the couch with you. That would be a dream come true. My heart is pounding just thinking about it. Come on! I'm waiting! Oh, she's talking. I hate how hard it is to form habits. There's so much stuff we're actually doing, it isn't hard. But forming the habit seems impossible. It just makes you feel so useless. Like you can't do anything right. I think the new generation suffers from it the most. Probably because we have a totally different set of skills than those who came before us. Thanks to the internet, we're really good at shifting through tons of information really quickly. But we're bad at doing things that don't give us instant gratification. I think of science if science, psychology, and education don't catch up in the next 10 or 20 years, then we're in trouble. But for the time being, if you're not one of the people who can conquer the problem, you might just have to live with feeling awful about yourself.
Yeah, that's me. I can't conquer problems that well. Well, I can conquer a lot of problems. Although school-related problems. When it comes to specific things, I can't answer it properly. But if I can't, if it's other things, I can't. So yeah. I'm not really a fan of cold weather, are you? Not really. If I had to choose between too cold and too hot, I would always pick too hot. When you're cold, it can actually be painful. Your fingers get numb, and if you wear gloves, you can't use your phone. So inconvenient. But when it's too hot, it's not that hard to stay cool with the cold drink or by staying in the shade. Although, I do have to admit one thing. Cold weather makes for better cuddle weather. You gonna actually progress the story, or are you just gonna do this all day? By the way, I might actually cut our waiting times out, because the waiting times are just stupid now. It's like, hey, yeah, you're waiting, yeah! I think the most important skill in life is being able to fake confidence. I'm pretty convinced that everyone feels at least a little bit scared and alone. But being able to trick others into thinking you have it all together? That's the key of getting people to respect and admire you. I think I got pretty good at that over the years. I don't show my weaknesses very often. But because of that, I haven't had many people I could really open up to. I mean, when do you reach the point in a friendship where you can just express your vulnerabilities? Anyway, that's one reason I'm so glad I have you now. I feel like I'm a little bit less scared and alone when you're here with me. Do you feel the same way? I really want to be that person for you. Come to talk about it, talk about it, talk about it. Hey, what's your favorite game? Mine is Doki Doki Literature Club. Oh, wow! That was a joke. But if you tell me you like some other romance game better, I might get a little jealous. Yes, I like, Romance in the Highest? Is that a game? Can I say that's a game? Hey, Jim, can we create a game called Romance of the Highest? Okay, we're creating that game. Haha, that's my favorite game now. Back in my debate club days, I learned a whole lot of arguing. The problem with arguing is that each person sees their opinion as the superior one. That's kind of stating the obvious, but its effects the way they try to get their point across. Let's say you really like a certain movie, right? If someone comes along and tells you the movie sucks because it did X and Y wrong, doesn't that make you feel kind of personally attacked? It's because by saying that, it's like they're implying that you have bad taste. And once emotions enter the picture, it must guarantee that both people will be left sour. But it's all about language. If you make everything as subjective sounding as possible, then people will listen to you without feeling attacked. You could say I'm personally not a fan of it, and I felt that I'd like it more if it did X and Y things like that. It even works when you're citing facts about things. If you say I read on this website that it works like this, or if you admit that you're not an expert on it, then it's much more like you're putting your knowledge on the table, rather than forcing it onto them. If you put in an active effort to keep the decision mutual and level, they usually follow suit. Sweet. Then you can share your opinion without anyone getting upset, just from a disagreement. Plus, people will start saying you as open-minded and a good listener. It's a win-win, you know? Well, I guess that wouldn't be Monica's debate tip of the day. That sounds a little silly. Thanks for listening, though. What? Hey, did you know I'm vegetarian? I don't mean that like I'm breaking or anything. I just thought you'd enjoy a fun fact about me. I decided to start a couple years ago after learning more about Earth's climate. The carbon footprint of cultivating livestock is just unbelievable. Anyway, I decided it's not much of a personal sacrifice to just stop contributing to the whole mess. What is that so strange of a reason? Well, I guess a lot of people are more concerned about it being inhumane and all that. I don't really care as much about that part. It's weird, like, we don't only care about killing the things that we personally relate to as a species. Most people are fine when killing bugs because they're icky. And of course, we all kill billions of microorganisms daily without even giving it, though. But suddenly, if they're just a little bit bigger, it's murder. I mean, what if plants feel some kind of pain too, and we just don't understand it? But they do, because plants are alive and they have feelings too. They say some plants know when they're being killed and can feel it. What if pulling leaves off a stem feels like someone ripping off your fingers one by one? That would hurt so much. I'm just saying, we're a pretty biased species if you think about that. Anyway, if you ever feel like making a small contribution to the plant, it doesn't hurt to choose veggies once in a while. Even if we ever have dinner together and you just did it for me, that would be really romantic. Okay, I'm going to delete you now. Ba 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 da ba ba da 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 da. Okay. I got bored of you, Monica.
What's happening? Keegan, what's happening to me? It hurts.
Yeah, of course it hurts.
It hurts so much. Help me, Keegan. Please hurry and help me. Help me. Did you do this to me, Keegan? Did you delete me?
Yes. I did delete you.
How could you? How could you do this to me? You were all I had left.
Yeah, exactly.
I sacrificed everything for us to be together. Everything. I loved you so much, Keegan. I trusted you. Do you just want to torture me? Watch me suffer? Were you only pretending to be kind just to hurt me even more? I never thought anyone could be as horrible as you are. You win, okay? You win! You killed everyone! I hope you're happy. There's nothing left now. You can stop playing. Go find some other people to torture. Keegan? You completely, truly make me sick. Goodbye.
Hello?
I still love you. I can't help it. What's wrong with me? How horrible am I for you to hate me this much? All my friends. I did so many awful things. So many selfish and disgusting things. I shouldn't have done all of this. I'm just messing up a world that I don't even belong in. A world that you wanted to be a part of. I ruined it. I ruined everything. Maybe that's why you deleted me.
Yeah, that's why. I deleted you.
Because I destroyed everything that you wanted. How could I do that to someone I love? That's not love. That's
jealousy? Jealousy? Question mark?
I've made up my mind. Keegan, I know I said that I deleted everyone else, but that was kind of an exaggeration. I couldn't find it in myself to do it. Even though I know they weren't real, they were still my friends. I love them all. And I love the Literature Club. I really did love the Literature Club. That's why I'm going to do this. I know it's the only way for everyone to be happy. If I really love you... Then...
Hey! This game is not suitable for children. Or those... Yep. Oh! She's Monica's not there. Look at that. Look at that. They're back. Sayori's back. Sayori's back in town. What if I just... Okay, anyway. There's no game to load to, so I guess new game. It's an ordinary school day like any other. Oh no. As usual, I'm surrounded by couples and friend groups walking to school together. I always tell myself it's about time I meet some girls or something like that. Hey, Keegan. It's Sayori! Sayori, you're back! Well, there already is one girl. That girl's Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. We used to walk to school together every day, and recently we've picked up that habit once again. Keegan, are you proud of me? For what? You know, for waking up on time. Well, you've been doing that for a while now. Uh-huh. But you never even said anything about it, even though we walk to school together every day. Well, you know, I always thought it was implied. It's embarrassing to say out loud. Come on, please. It's good motivation. Fine. I'm proud of you, Sayori. I can finally say that again. Because Sayori is back in town. She's back in black. Except she's not. Because she ain't wearing black, she's wearing gray. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute. By the way, Keegan, have you decided on a club to join yet? A club? I told you already. I'm really not. I start to say what I always do, that I'm not interested in joining any clubs. But something tells me Sayori would take more offense to that than now. After all, how could I tell her that clubs are a waste of time when she's starting a club of her very own? Actually, yeah. I think I've decided on a club. Really? Which one? Tell me. I think I'll keep it a surprise. Boo! You meanie. Be patient. You'll find out soon enough. I used to ask myself why I left myself get lectured by such a carefree girl, but I started to realize that, in a way, I envy her. When Sayori puts her mind on something, she can accomplish great things. So that's why I feel like I should do something special for her. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I packed up my things, I stand up gathering my motivation. Let's see. I recall the room numbers of the clubs from the flyer I saw. I walk across the school and upstairs a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for a third year classes as activities. Before long, I find the room. I timidly open the door in front of me. Hello? Ah! Keegan! What are you doing here? Well, I glance around the room. Okay, there's Natsuki. So you're the Keegan that Sayori always talks about. Thank you for stopping by, Achiri. And we know this already for like the 5 to 6 or 7 hours I've played this game. It's a pleasure to meet you, Keegan. We're the literature club. Oh wow, chicka. I hope you enjoyed your visit. Come on, Yuri. No need to be so formal. He's gonna think we're really strict or something. Sorry, Natsuki. The tall one, whose name is apparently Yuri, seems to be quite shy compared to the others. In comparison, the girl named Natsuki, despite her size, seems like the affected one. Well, it's nice to meet both of you. I look forward to working with you.
What? Working? Keegan, don't tell me.
That's right.
The club I've decided to join is yours, Sayori. The Literature Club.
Sayori's eyes lighten up. No way! No way! Ah! Why am I... Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey! And if Sayori is this happy, then I'm sure it won't be as bad. It won't be so bad to have you around. Not to mention there's four of us now. That means we can become an official recognized club. I don't know what to say. We have to celebrate. What? Who? That's what I'm guessing. What an appropriate day for that, isn't it? Yeah! After all, Natsuki decided to... Hey! Don't ruin the surprise. Sorry. Everyone sit down at the table, okay? How about I make some tea as well? Yeah, we're doing this schmuck again. She's gonna make some cupcakes and some tea! Ah! The girls have a few desks around, arranged to form a table. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki... Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table with the tray in her hands. Okay, are you ready? Ta-da! Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats. Like in the first episode of the game! The whiskers are drawn with icing and little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears. So cute! Wow, that looks amazing. Well, you know, just hurry and take one. Sayori grabs one first, then I follow. It's delicious! Sayori talks with her mouth full. Full and has already managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcake around in my fingers looking for the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. She waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. Thank you, Natsuki. Well, of course it is. I'm a pro after all. I read manga. I read manga. Yeah! There's no need to thank me or anything. As Natsuki struggles to accept the compliment, Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the tea pot next to the cupcake tray. You keep a whole tea set in this classroom? Don't worry, the teacher gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book? I guess. Already trying to impress our new member, Yuri. Can I skip this? I mean, that you know, need. I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be my. Yep, I'm glad. Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. So, Keegan, what kind of things do you like to read? Well, considering how little I've read in the past. Yep, manga. I mutter quietly to myself. Natsuki, yep. We've already read this. Got slobber on my mouth, on my chin. I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri? Well, let's see. Yuri chooses. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in. Yep, but you know, I like a lot of love. Don't feel intimidated if you don't read much. Okay, yay. I'm certain we can find something that we have in common. Hey, Yuri. Eh? Well, about you. About, you know. The first thing he said. Manga. That's right. Natsuki tends to read manga in the club room. Don't just say that. Say it. For some reason, Natsuki seems embarrassed about it. Okay, this is different. I'm glad I clicked off. Besides, manga is literature too, you know. So if Keegan wants to read some of my manga, then don't try to stop him or anything. Natsuki, it would be such a thing. However, it could also be nice for us to diversify ourselves a little. He can take this opportunity to try something new as well. Wouldn't you agree, Keegan? Maybe, sensing the tension, Sayori jumps in. Maybe we can all try something new. I think it could be fun. And well, I'll get to know each other a little bit better, too. I mean, that's the kind of thing literature clubs do, right? I don't disagree or anything. Yeah, you're right, as usual. You're right, as usual, President. Guess that means I should try picking up a novel or something, huh? Well, that would make two of us. I wouldn't mind doing it. I wouldn't mind doing it if I'm not the only one. Then as for Yuri, I have to read manga? Jeez. You were the one who suggested we diversify. You should be a little more open-minded. It's kind of hurtful. Hurtful? I didn't realize. With a guilty expression, Yuri thinks to herself. I'm sorry for disrespecting your interest, Natsuki. If you're into it, then I'm sure it's a worth form of literature. Are you just saying that? No. I realized my error. So if you're willing to consider starting a novel, then I'll offer my... Obviously, it's been an hour now, but you kind of clearly realized that I gave up on the voices a long time ago after what happened. Then I'll offer my gratitude by finding a manga to read as well. Really? I mean, it makes me happy that you do that for me, Yuri. You can trust me to find something that you'll really like, okay? Same here. Perhaps I'll visit the bookstore after the club meeting. Just you? Would you like to come along with me? If you don't mind. Not at all. I always go alone, so... Yeah, me too. This is so cute! Sorry. Shut it. I'll show you some manga there too, okay? Yes. I look forward to it. Natsuki and Yuri start to clean up the food. I guess the meeting's over, huh? Yeah, looks like it. It's nice to see everyone getting along. Isn't it? I think everyone likes you too, Keegan. You think so? Well, everyone always seems to get along a little better with you around, Sayori. Well, everyone always seems to get along a little better with you around, Sayori. Aw, Keegan. Don't say something like that. It's embarrassing. Well, whatever. I was surprised when you told me you were starting a club. But I think you're pulling it off just fine. One sec. Okay, there's nothing. Sorry, I went back to the files just to see if Monica left something. Like all the characters have so far. Except Natsuki, because she got deleted. At the beginning of the video, yeah. But I think you're pulling it off just fine. We're gonna make it the best club ever! Now that you joined, every day is gonna be so much fun! Hey, Keegan. I really want to thank you. I hate it when the music stops. You know I hate it when the music stops. I mean, I'm really happy that you joined the club and everything, but the truth is, I already knew you were going to. There's actually something else. I want to thank you for getting rid of Monica.
What now? What is she talking about?
What?! That's right. I know everything that she did. Maybe it's because I'm the president now. But I really know everything, Keegan. I know how hard you tried to make everyone happy. I know about all of the awful things that Monica did to make everyone really sad. But none of that matters anymore. It's just us now. And you made me the happiest girl in the whole world. I can't wait to spend every day like this with you. Forever and ever. F.
O-R-E-V-E. No.
Okay. Say Ori.
What's happening?
I won't let you hurt him, okay?
Who? It hurts. Ah!
I'm sorry, I was wrong. There's no happiness here after all. Goodbye, Sayori. Goodbye, Keegan. Goodbye, Literature Club.
Can you hear me? Hi, it's me.
Hi?
So, you know how I've been, like, practicing piano and stuff?
Monica?
Not really any good at it yet, like, at all. But I wrote you a song, and I was kind of hoping that I could show it to you, because I worked really, really hard on it. So,
what? Music, audio, DDLC. Okay? Excuse me, what?
Every day, I imagine a future where I can be with you.
Yes!
In my hand is a pen that will write a poem of me and you.
Wow. This is cool.
Special day.
Yeah! Wow! That's the end! Wow! Concept and game design. Dance up. Whoa! They're removing images. They're deleting all the art. There's my thumbnails. Wait, did... Okay. Never mind. Okay, I'm guessing these are images we didn't actually find in the game. I found this one. That was the thumbnail for number two. Doodle doodle doo.
Is it love if I take your is it love if I set you?
I'm guessing the static ones mean that we didn't actually find them. Hey!
The ink flows down into a dark puddle. How can I write love into reality?
Special thanks to Monica and Keegan. Hey! My name is actually there! They're removing the game. Made with Love by Team Cell. Thank you, Team. This is my final goodbye to the Literature Club. I finally understand the Literature Club is truly a place where no happiness can be found. To the very end, it continued to expose innocent minds to a horrific reality. Reality that our world's not designed to comprehend. I can't let any of my friends undergo that same hellish I can't let any of my friends undergo the same hellish epiphany. Okay. For the time it lasted, I want to thank you for making all of my dreams come true, for being a friend to all the club members, and most of all, thank you for being a part of my literature club. With everlasting love, Monica. Oh, man!
Error, script file is missing or corrupted. Please reinstall the game. Whoa! Okay, let me just say, this is the end of the video. That was amazing. The team who created this game, I loved it. 10 out of 10. I understand why it's called a psychological horror novel, like novel and all that stuff, because you gotta read and all that. But yeah, this game was amazing. Top notch. But yeah, anyway, thank you guys for watching this video. Subscribe and like to see some more videos. If you liked it, leave a like. Until my next video. I will see you guys when I see you guys. Peace.